everyone, my name's Debbie and I run JMP Music. We are here today to show you all the wonderful opportunities you can have with music, either learning a musical instrument or through singing. You're all at a great age to start learning and you can do this either in school where teachers come in during the school day or at home where you can learn online. All of our teachers make it fun to learn and they cover all types of music so you can choose what you want to play. You can have lessons in groups so that you can learn with your friends or you can have lessons on your own. There will be chances for you to perform in school to show your friends what you've learned. You can do grades and exams if you want to and even join orchestras and bands when you are older. How cool. Sit back and enjoy while some of our teachers talk about what you can learn.
Hi everyone, my name is Scott McKeown and I teach guitar and ukulele for JMP Music. So I thought today, just give you a quick demonstration of what these instruments can do. So first up, we have the electric guitar. This tends to be people's favourites. And I was trying to think of a song that we could play where you guys could jam along to it and nod your head wherever you are, if you're in the classroom or whatever. So I went for this one, hopefully you guys know it. So that was the electric guitar. Were you guys nodding your head? If you were, can you put your hand up? All right, cool. So next up, we're going to look at the acoustic guitar, and you can have lessons with this as well. So this is kind of like the electric, but it's a lot kind of softer, kind of cleaner sounding. So you'd kind of have Taylor Swift and Ed Sheeran and people like that would be using this. So you'd have like... So yeah, that's the acoustic guitar, which is great too. And then finally, we have the ukulele. So the ukulele is this awesome instrument. It's really small, and it's a Hawaiian instrument. And yeah, it's just, you can just make such kind of nice, lovely sounds on it. And yeah, you can learn this at any age as well, so it's kind of really cool for that reason too. So I was trying to think of a song that would be good to showcase this, and I thought I'd go with a song off Moana. I don't know if you guys have seen that, but yeah, let's go for a bit of this.
See the light when the sky is the sea.
And that's the ukulele. That wasn't me singing, by the way. Well, thank you for watching this. I really appreciate it. And yeah, you can sign up for electric guitar or acoustic guitar or ukulele lessons if you'd like to. Just kind of ask your teacher about where you can get a form to do it. So thank you guys, take care, bye-bye.
Hi there, I'm Russell, and I love to play the piano. Now, the piano was invented about 300 years ago in Italy. And before pianos were invented, the only other keyboard around to play was something called a harpsichord. Now, the thing with a harpsichord was that if you played the key soft or hard, the same volume came out. It sounded something like this. That's a harpsichord. So, when a piano was invented though, if you press the key soft, you got a quieter sound. And piano in Italian means soft and quiet. But if you press the key harder, you get a louder sound. So, originally they were called piano fortes, which is soft and loud, because loud in Italian is forte. So, I've put together a few tunes that I hope you recognise that demonstrate how to play the piano loudly and softly. Let's see if you can recognise any of these.
John, and I'm here today to give you a demonstration on the keyboard. Now, the keyboard is one of the most popular instruments that you can learn in school, and it's ideal for anyone learning in Key Stage 1 and Key Stage 2. Okay, now, I'm here with my piano today, okay, which doubles up as a keyboard. We've got all the keyboard functions that we need, okay, and I'll show you those in just a minute. Okay, now, when we learn the keyboard, we play all our tunes with our right hand, okay, and one of the great things about the keyboard is that you can actually play your tunes with lots of different voices, lots of different sounds. So you can have traditional piano sounds. Okay, you can have electric piano sounds. I'm sure you'll know this one as well. You can have things like organ sounds, so you can have big cathedral organ sounds. Okay, and you can even have a keyboard set up to be a whole choir. Okay, so the other great thing about keyboards is they all have their built-in drum machines. Okay, so we have lots of different sounds that we can use with our right hand, lots of different drum beats that we can use with our left hand. Okay, and our left hand plays the chords. Okay, so we've got drum beats going on, we've got our tunes going on with our right hand, we've got chords going on with our left hand. Okay, and I'm going to demonstrate those now. So I'm going to play a short medley of songs. We've got four songs. I'm sure you know them all. Very, very popular songs over the last 4 or 5 years. Okay, and what we're going to do is we're just going to switch on our drum beat first with our chords. Okay, and then we're going to come in with our right hand. And here we go. Thank you. There we go. I'm sure you recognised all of those songs, okay? And with the keyboard, it's not just pop songs that we can learn, okay? Like a lot of instruments that we offer, okay? You can have film music, you can learn Disney songs, musicals, TV theme tunes, lots and lots of different ones, okay? And also work towards grades and exams, okay? And work you through and take you through those. So I hope you enjoyed the keyboard demonstration and hope to see you sign up for lessons. Bye for now.
Hi guys and welcome. My name is Lauren Porter and I teach one of the most exciting instruments of all time, the voice. I teach singing lessons. I've been a professional singer now for the last 17 years and I've been teaching for 5 to 6 years. It's not only super, super fun, but we also work on warm-ups, breathing and technique. And all of the songs that we work on during the term are chosen by you. So whether it be a Disney song or a pop song or maybe even a rock song, we can do any song that you wish to do. Now, by having singing lessons, these can lead to maybe an assembly performance or a school concert or a special event and even graded singing music exams. So super, super exciting. Now, singing lessons can be one-on-one, so just me and you, in a pair, maybe with your best friend or in a group of up to 5. So lots and lots of choices to be made. Now, in the meantime, I have recorded a couple of my favourite songs at the moment, just so you can see what sort of songs and what sort of things we could do in singing lessons. So here you go, enjoy, and I'll see you in a minute. I'll get lots of you sign up for singing lessons and I'll see you all really, really soon. Take care.
Hi guys, my name's Rory Hill and I'm one of the drum tutors here at JMP Music. Right here behind me you can see a drum kit. So this is an acoustic drum kit. And in the lessons, which you'll see me play in a few seconds, we'll be playing on a slightly different drum kit and it's called an electronic drum kit. Just because it's a bit quieter and it's more suitable for playing in schools. What you can expect from the lessons is we mostly play songs that you guys want to play. So if there's any music that you like, any songs that you like the sound of and you think you'd like to learn on the drums, you can bring them in. You just tell me what they are and we can start learning them straight away. later on, if you want to, you can do exams and things like that. You can get certificates for your progress. But you don't have to do that. It's totally up to you. You can just learn songs if that's what you want to do. And so the most important thing about the drums is the timing. Okay, so when you're playing in a band, you've got the keyboard player, the guitarist, the vocalist, and they all have to play at a certain speed, right? And so the drummer's job is very important. We have to keep everybody playing at the same speed. Okay, so if everyone's playing at different speeds, it's just going to sound like a complete mess, right? So the drummer is very important. They have to keep everybody in time. So now I'm just going to play a few songs for you on the kit that we're probably going to be using in the lesson, on the electronic kit. So yeah, I hope you enjoy and hope to see you soon.
Hi, my name's Simon and I teach trumpet and cornet and various other brass instruments. The trumpet, here's a trumpet, is mainly used for jazz and orchestral work and for fanfares to celebrate the Queen's birthday. It's a bright sound and cuts through the rest of the orchestra. This is what it sounds like. Is a slightly different instrument. The cornet is shorter than the trumpet and is designed for a marching band or a brass band. It uses the same mouthpiece like this and it uses the same vowels, but it's more melodic. It's a more melodic instrument. It has a sweeter, more rounded sound. It was invented for the brass band. And it's easier to use because it's shorter. It sounds like this. Sweeter sound. They make them in various different colours. This one's in brass. They also make silver ones. And they even make multicoloured ones as well. So the good thing about playing a brass instrument is that you can play any brass instrument with valves and a mouthpiece, if you learn one of them. So that's why it's a very flexible way of learning to play music. And that's it really. I hope to see you in my next lessons, next term.
So what do you think? You want to play a musical instrument or learn how to sing? then all you have to do is speak to your parents, collect an application form from the school office, and ask a grown-up to send the form in with all your details on. We can't wait to get you all started.